guys, guess who is on Amazon?
Hands up in the air. I just want the baddest bitch in the world right here on my lap. And I'ma hit this drink up like it's my last. I'ma hit this night up like it's my last. I'ma like it's my last. I swear I'ma do it like I never had it at all.
I'm actually in here. I'm so sorry. I have on no makeup. My hair is messed up. I'm missing two nails. Okay, and my room is dirty. Yeah, it's dirty. Anyways, I just wanted to get on here and do a quick video for you guys because today is the day. I'm so excited. I've been waiting, praying, hoping, being faithful on this. I finally got the paperback version of my book, Life, and it's now available on Amazon.com. Can you say the come up? Yeah! Oh, yeah! I am so excited, guys. You have no idea with Amazon, like I talked about in my last video, how much you have to go through with the submission process. But guys, it's been troublesome. I got the flu a couple weeks ago, getting ready for summer school, just trying to organize and build capital. I did the Black Expo. I've been marketing, working my butt off. It's hump month is what I call it. Most people will say like hump day. I call it hump month because the month of May leading until June for financial aid. I don't know anybody else who's experiencing this. For college students, you know how it is. It's like, it's crazy, crazy, crazy right now. But I definitely had to get on here. I know I'm not completely dressed and looking all spiffified like I usually do. I don't know if that's a word, but I wanted to get on here and just let you guys know that my book is now available on Amazon.com, Create Space eStore. I'm working on, I'll actually be doing the audiobook tomorrow. I'll be working on starting recording the audiobook, and the ebook will be available on the Kindle's eStore. It'll be in the iTunes store, or the Apple store. It will be on Smashwords and CD Baby. That's what I'm working on right now, and then after that it'll be everywhere. I'm working on, me and my marketing people are working on national exposure. So that's the updates on everything. I'm looking forward to the African Americans Moving on the Move Book Club Awards, that I will be the featured author on the bus. We're going to be traveling up to D-Town, that's Dallas, for those of you who don't know. I'll be going to Dallas to read all the way there. And then that'll be with Brandy Randolph of Bad Girl of Urban Lit. She did an editorial on my book that's on her site, editingcouture.com. I'll put that link up too so you guys can check it out. I just hope everybody's having an empowering week. I hope everybody is pushing through. I know it's hot outside. I don't know who all is watching this from Houston, but it is scorching outside. This is the peak of summer. The summer solstice is not until June 11th, and it's barely June, and it's crazy. So I just want to get on here, though, and talk a little bit about patience, because when I do my videos, you know, a lot of people underestimate me. They have no idea how much of a struggle it is to be in business, first of all, being a woman in business, being a college student in business. All of you guys out there, even with full-time jobs in college and doing all these extracurricular activities in school and high school, everything, people don't realize each other's struggles until they're mentioned. But I don't say everything when I'm on my videos because it's normally too much and I don't want to talk you guys to death. But I really wanted to touch on today on patience, and I probably talked about that in my other videos, but this has been a journey. You guys watching know that this has been an incredible journey that we've all been, everybody who's watching this show, you have your own struggles in your own life and everything that you're doing, and so you I'm sure you've been journeying right along with me, and I just wanted to touch on the subject of patience on a mature note, because I'm 18 now, there's more things that I can share. And I just really want to reflect on how much patience it's going to take when you get out there and you start accomplishing your dreams. If it's to get an A on a paper in school, or you're trying to apply for a new job, or you're starting a business, you're writing a book, or you want to do a movie. Whatever you want to do, I don't know how bad you want it. Obviously, you guys can see how bad I want my dreams and how much I'm encouraging other people to really badly want their dreams. But when you really, really focus on what you want and how badly you want it, you have to take the time out to do things right. I mean, I cannot stress that enough with the creation of my book, and I'm talking to various mentors right now. I probably have like 5 or 6 mentors. Big shout outs to Sir Nemesis Truth, big shout outs to Kath Aviva, big shout outs to my grandmother, Rosie Brazel, my aunts, both of them. Big shout outs to all my mentors, Jim Hernandez, Raheem Brooks, Brandy Randolph. Oh my goodness, I have so many mentors. But it takes that. It takes a lot of mentorship and a lot of patience to craft your craft. It's not like you're going to wake up in the morning and establish a business overnight, or if you're an aspiring basketball player, you have to practice shooting those hoops. You have to practice every little thing. If you want to be in competition and be a force to be reckoned with in competition, you don't want to just step out there and you don't have anything to offer. You don't have a mature talent. You can have skill, but is it adept? Is it something you took time on? Is it something that you really put your effort into? And it takes time. I'm really dealing with that right now. I'm really, really dealing with patience right now. Amazon took a long time. My book's been out since December, and I just got on Amazon. I'm just doing an ebook because the promotion, being in school, and even if I wasn't in school, it takes a long time to get out there, guys. But things happen under the wire, and that's why you have to be patient. You have to wait, because as soon as you give up, do you guys notice that? Like, as soon as you're working for something, as soon as you say, oh my gosh, I'm not going to do this anymore, that opportunity passes you right by. Like, you notice, like, if you're at a red light, as soon as you say, okay, I'm going to make a right turn and come back around and do a U-turn, that the light turns green just for you to make that left turn to the intersection. Just little things like that when you're rushing, and don't take time to realize that it takes time to develop your craft, is what I'm saying. Just big things going on right now. I'm trying to build myself as a motivational speaker. I'm trying to gather information to craft the outline, to watch movies, more movies, and learn more about the film industry to write my screenplay. So everything is a developmental process right now. Most of the money that's coming into my business is going out because it's capital intensive right now. Things cost money. Promotion costs money. Things take time. They take time. And so I just really wanted to reach you guys on that level of just taking your time, because I'm okay with it. I'm okay with it taking time. I think of it as if, even if you have to work for something for 10 years and then for the rest of your life you're successful and wealthy and everything's going great, then it's wonderful, because the time and the effort that you're putting in right now, it'll pay off for you, and you will reap the amazing benefits and the rewards for all that you endure. And it's important. It's important to be patient. So I do have a poem in my book. Of course I have a poem. Do I have a poem? Of course I have a poem in my book. Just for you guys. For anybody who already has the book, I always say, whoop, this is on page 48. And this poem is called Wait. There's nothing but time in these days. Nothing but days in these years. For every ounce of patience we display, we receive kindly events that are dear. Virtues bring us the best, because time unfolds on its own. Allow time, and you will be blessed. a life worth living, you will be shown. The best things are always prolonged. Every pearl needs time to form. Your fate will never be wrong. Destiny's treasures you will adore. We have nothing but moments to share. There's nothing but minutes to spare. Breathe only in the moment of one breath. Live life with no thoughts of death. Great jewels will flow with the wind. With the weeks, all hurt ends. All yearnings we have in this month will eventually transform into wants. Those wants will be needs we create that we will acquire if only we wait. Oh, life, you guys. Life is full of waiting. You can't rush today, so it'll be tomorrow, because then you'll be wanting to rush tomorrow, so it'll be the next day. So, I'm learning that the hard way. That's right. My book is called Life, and I'm living it. So, as always, I just want to get on here and share that little piece of me with you guys, and hopefully you'll learn to take things slowly and let your pearls form, because one day you'll have a jewelry shop. Was that corny? I'm sorry. You get the message. Tune in next week. Be patient. Stay encouraged. Stay empowered. Buy my book on Amazon. And be successful. See you guys next week or when I make another video. Bye-bye.
Fly with the stars in the skies. I am no longer trying to survive. I believe that life is a prize, but to live doesn't mean you're alive. Don't worry about me and who I fire. I get what I desire, it's my empire. And yes, I call the shots, I am the umpire. I sprinkle holy water upon the vampire. In this very moment, I'm king. In this very moment, I slay Goliath with a sling. This very moment, I bring, put it on everything. That I will retire with the ring, and I will retire with the crown. Yes, no, I'm not lucky, I'm blessed. Yes, clap for the heavyweight champ, me. But I couldn't do it all alone. We, young money raised me, grew up out in Paisley, Southside Jamaica, Queens, and it's crazy. Cause I'm still hood, Hollywood couldn't change me. Shout out to my haters, sorry that you couldn't faze me. Ain't being cocky, we just vindicated. Best believe that when we done, this moment will be syndicated. I don't know, this night just remind me of everything they deprived me of. Put your drinks up, it's a celebration every time we link up. We done did everything they could think of. Greatness is what we wanna bring up.
I wish that I could have this moment for life. For life. For life. Cause in this moment